Hey, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, how's it going out there today? Happy New Year. Welcome back, first of all, one and all, to the Boston Fans 79 V1 YouTube channel. What is the good word? And today I am accompanied by my brethren, my brother from another mother. We are the NC Connection. This is...
David Rivera. What's going on?
That's right. And what channel do you run here on YouTube, David?
That would be the Fort Minor Project channel, a.k.a. David Rivera.
That's right. That's right. The Fort Minor Project, a.k.a. David Rivera YouTube channel. Please don't forget to subscribe to him, share his channel, give him a follow on Facebook, friend request him on Facebook, follow him on Twitter, as well as Instagram. So yeah,
same thing for you on my end, too. Definitely.
Yeah, follow me, subscribe to me, whatever you guys got to do. Just do it, okay? Today, yes, of course, is Saturday, January the 14th, 2017. Mm-hmm. Rolling right through the, you know, first month of the year, you know. This is unbelievable. And so, what did we do today, David?
Well, today we actually went out, did a couple of stuff. We were actually on an action figure toy hunt, looking at different figures to see what's around. We went to a couple of stores, and... it took a little while, but we went to the right store that did very well for us. So it took a little bit, but we were able to pull it off in the end, to say the very least.
Yeah, we really did. I mean, everything seemed to come into fruition, if you will, because the first store that we went to, they had some decent things, but they didn't have much.
No.
The second store we went to, they seem to have downgraded their stock, okay? They don't seem to have as much, you know, because we see all the time, like Grimm's Toy Show. Mm-hmm. It seems like every single time that he goes to his Toys R Us, he finds something cool. And today, with Toys R Us... we seem to have hit a flat tire. And that is by no means a literal sense of my car having a flat tire.
No.
But it was... Toys R Us, I'm sorry. It was a bust.
And yeah, then... that was really odd. Especially for Toys R Us. I can understand, yeah, it's after the holidays, but now...
yeah, it's...
very little to nothing.
Basically. Right, but still, you know, I mean, it's... after, you know... we're here on the second week of January.
Yeah.
The holidays, yes, are over.
Mm-hmm.
You would think that that Toys R Us would do some restocking.
Yeah.
But after Toys R Us, we went to the Walmart in Cary, mm-hmm. where they didn't have the best selection, but they had a few surprises. They had... you know, they might be older figures, but still some great figures, in my opinion, especially from the elite section.
Oh, yeah. So with that being said, I was able to get a couple of things, same thing with him.
Yep.
And it was actually very surprising, so we're able to actually show that. So we got the bags.
Yep.
And I do have the first bag, at least for mine anyway. From FYE before we get to the Walmart stuff.
Yep.
So, also with this, I got basically two things, something I've been wanting for a while, and I'm starting to collect these, which is the pop vinyls.
Yep, the pop vinyls, and he got none other than Wedding Day Rollins.
Had to get this one. Been wanting to get some Shield stuff, if you will. Same thing with the regular figures, so I saw this one. There was a couple other ones, yes, but this one is the FYE exclusive, so definitely had to pick this one up.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's a good pop vinyl figure.
Yeah.
Because I've got it right on my shelf.
Oh, yeah. So this one is definitely going home. Since I have the Kevin Owens as my very first one, and my second one is Mr. Seth Rollins, which is dope. And then had to go back to FYE and, of course, get me another chocolate bar. And
that's a good one.
Yeah.
That's
and Big Cass one.
I think that's the first one I ever tried from them. Yeah. And that the marshmallow and the milk chocolate on that one.
Yeah.
Ooh. Love it.
Yeah, very tempting, so probably have this a little later.
Yeah, that's the thing. They are so tempting because as of right now, we are going to be watching the UK tournament at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And so that's one of our little snacks.
Yeah.
He's going to have his candy bar, and I got mine, okay? Yeah. I did go to FYE as well, mm-hmm. and but I only got one thing, and that was a chocolate bar. And I got, speaking of Seth Rollins, I got the Architects chocolate. Redesign, rebuild, reclaim. So I cannot wait to put this one. When I'm finished with the candy bar, I'm going to be putting this wrapper on my wall, just like I have my other ones that I've had. So, Seth Rollins, the Architects Milk Chocolate.
Nice.
It's going to be a go for me. So that's the first thing that we wanted to show you. I made a pickup at Kmart. As much as, like, I don't want to say it was a complete bust, but they did have some good figures, okay? Some of them, though, the packaging was ripped. Mm. Ripped open, even if it was like a really big slit on the side.
Yeah,
Yeah, it really is a shame. Because for me, I know, like, I like to keep my figures, you know, still in the packaging as, you know, I'm sure, you know, like, especially on David's channel, you can see a little bit more.
Yeah.
But I did make a pickup at Kmart.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this was the bag it came in. And they had the blue light special on for us today.
Yeah, we got lucky with that.
But I got Dean Ambrose's girlfriend.
Yeah.
I got Renee Young. Okay? And the set for this one is actually not too bad. Okay? John Cena, Randy Orton, Brock, Seth, Kalisto, Renee Young, Kofi Kingston, and Luke Harper. And so, not a bad pickup in my opinion. The articulation on the face, I would have thought that the Joker from 1990, the 1990s Batman, got to Renee Young. I mean, within all seriousness, you know, look at this face and the articulation. It's so messed up. Unbelievable, but yeah, it's just another thing I wanted to add to my collection, and so there's that. And last but not least, Brother David, what did you pick up at Walmart when we went to Walmart?
This one was very interesting. I do have two action figures, and one of them I've been looking for quite a while, and that is the Paige.
Yep, Paige.
Yep.
Paige guy, Raphael Leduc.
Just Leduc. There
this
you go.
Is for Brother Leduc.
Yeah, so thumbs up for that. I like the one that you have, but this one was an interesting find.
Yeah.
Since you had that one, I was just looking at any sort of a Paige figure. I only saw the zombie one, but I wasn't really caring for that too much. I just wanted at least either that one, the one that you have, or something like this.
Yeah, because I got my Paige, okay, when I first started collecting, okay, and Grimm's Toy Show had actually showed it off. I have the Elite that has both the NXT Women's Championship and the Divas Championship. So, you know, with that being said, you know, it was when she first, she transitioned from NXT to when she beat AJ Lee on Monday Night Raw for the Divas Championship. So that's where pretty much that one comes from. It doesn't. Yeah. She has the purple outfit blind with black. So that is one figure I vowed to, if I ever got rid of my figures, I vowed to never get rid of that one because that one's probably my one of my favorites, okay, that I have.
Yeah, that one's amazing, especially with the titles and everything.
Yeah.
So, now that I got Paige, I might get a built-in video, we'll see. Because I did see him with the Elite, like I mentioned earlier, with the U.S. title. So, that Paige might have a built-in video, we'll see.
Yep.
If he's still around.
And then, yeah, I mean, I did see It did have an Alberto Del Rio.
Yeah, I think it was a basic one.
It was the there was a basic Alberto Del Rio at Toys R Us, I want to say it was.
Yeah, so with Paige, I did get an Elite figure, and it was kind of high up, and we had some help with that, so...
Yeah, there's a whole there is a whole story and stuff behind this. I mean, it is just, we'll tell you the story in a little bit, but show them what you got for your Elite figure.
Well, this one, I figure since especially is not so much really around anymore, and then who knows when you could even see him back again, or hell, even see the figure again. So with that being said, I got a Hulk Hogan action figure.
Brother
indeed. So I know despite the whole shit that he's been through and stuff like that, but you know what he's done with wrestling, at least I still like what he's done for wrestling, not with the other stuff, but you know, it is what it is, and it's a shame, but hey, I thought it was pretty interesting, and it isn't that bad of an Elite figure, I will say.
And hey, it's Hulk Hogan.
Exactly.
It is the Hulkster. Okay. Yeah. I mean, you can't get any better than that. I mean, it's a really good figure.
It really is. Yeah.
You know, I mean, this Elite figure, I like the articulation of it.
Yeah.
It comes with two shirts. Mm-hmm. The one that he has on, which is the yellow, and then he's got the red one.
Yeah.
It's got his sunglasses and the boa.
Yeah, basically, probably one of my favorite eras for Hulk Hogan too. I actually pretty much grew up with this version of Hulk Hogan, seeing him back around like 2003, somewhere around there. When he came back and everything. So that one was a pretty cool time for Hulk Hogan, I thought, too, in my personal opinion.
Yeah, and that Hulk Hogan over there that's on that bar stool bench is the one I grew up with.
The Hasbro one.
Yeah, the Hasbro. Yeah. And then they did have the LJN version of that one. Right. If you you weren't a...
I think I've seen
you were just like maybe a baby when the... Actually, I don't think you were even born yet when they had the LJN figures, because those things came out early 80s.
Yeah, I've seen very different action figures, to these, to the ones I used to have, and then the smaller ones. So yeah, there's different ones. So yeah, it's good that too, that now they're having the Hasbro ones back too.
Yeah, and they did have the Hasbro figures. They had four of the characters of the Hasbro figures. They had...
Yeah.
Roman Reigns, John Cena, Brock Lesnar, Kevin Owens. Mm-hmm. They had those ones, but what I picked up, I don't regret. What I picked up, to me, far surpasses the new Hasbro figures.
Yeah.
And you know, David, speaking of Paige, my purchase from Walmart... And yes, they already saw it through the bag. But of course, my unbagging, my figure, comes complete with a bang. Diamond Dallas Page. Okay.
That was an awesome find.
This was a terrific find. Yeah. I mean, this is what I don't regret, okay? Mm-hmm. Getting Diamond Dallas Page is absolutely priceless.
Yeah.
They got the facts on the back. Mm-hmm. Ring attire. This is the 1997 ring attire.
Oh, yeah.
He's from the Jersey Shore. Signature move, the Diamond Cutter. WWE debut. It says 1990. And then height, 6'5". Signature phrase, that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing. So, got me some Diamond Dallas Page. And look for him to be in the WWE Hall of Fame class of 2017. Or that is it 2016?
2017. So hopefully it happens.
Yeah, I think he's already on the docket. I do believe that there is a definite that he's going to be in the Hall of Fame.
Oh yeah.
So
he deserves that.
I mean, and you got to think. I mean, he's an incredible wrestler.
Yeah.
Incredible character, and he actually saves people's lives.
Yeah.
With his DDP yoga, I mean, taking guys like Jake the Snake and Scott Hall, a.k.a. Razor Ramon, out from the pit as to which they were dwelling, from their alcohol abuse, drug addiction, the whole nine yards, but mostly alcohol, saving their lives with DDP yoga, Diamond Dallas Page. He is the man. So, that is what we picked up.
Oh, yeah.
But now we have to tell you the stories of Walmart, okay? I had seen the Diamond Dallas page. This was all the way up on like that very last shelf where they put the
Yeah,
overstock.
basically it's like up like that.
Yeah, you know, and I saw it from a distance, okay? And I'm like, and I saw the long name. I'm like, is that Diamond Dallas Page? I'm like, it is.
Yeah.
So, but I'm like, how the hell am I gonna get it? So, what I did was I took the first, because this was the behind the row that I
Yeah,
took
there was like
down.
three rows of
Yeah, there was
different
like two or three
figures.
rows, and so I went and I pulled down one of the stacks, okay? And then there were two guys with really long hair that came over, guys that were probably in their mid-30s. And, I had seen them in the next aisle over, kind of goofing around, playing with lightsabers, which is kind of funny. But then they came over, and, one of the guys started saying, "They have Doink the Clown." He's like, and he's saying to his friend or his brother, I don't know, they kind of looked alike. So I was thinking it's probably his brother, but he's like, "You remember Doink the Clown?" And so yeah, they're like, "Yeah." And he's like, "Oh, is there one of the guys?" He's like, "Is there one up there that you want?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm looking at that Diamond Dallas Page figure, and I'm like, I'm interested in it." And so he's like, "Do you need me to get it down for you?" I'm like, "Can you?" I'm like, "It's pretty high up there." He's like, "Yeah, no problem." And this guy was like probably 5'9" or whatever. Quite a bit. It was just enough to, to have him, reach that stack and pull it over. And then he ended up getting the figure down for me. I'm like,
Yeah, that's crazy.
yeah, I was like, thank you so much. He's like, I really appreciate it. Then he started, saying, some of the characters that were in there, like Goldust. He remembered Goldust. And he's like, that figure's pretty cool. And he was talking about Sting, and I'm like, yeah, I have two Stings at the house. I have the old Surfer Sting,
Yeah.
when he first debuted in WCW, and then I have the Crow Sting with the Ultimate Warrior, so in a battle pack. He's like, do you really? He's like, yeah. He's like, that's cool. And then he was mentioning that with the Hasbro figures that they need to put Sting as a Hasbro figure, which I hope they do at some point, but
I'm sure they will, yeah.
I know that some of the ones that they have now, Undertaker, Ultimate Warrior, Kevin Owens, Brock Lesnar, John Cena,
Yeah.
Roman Reigns, all that sort of thing. But then the other kind of like weird thing happened. We had this kid come over in the aisle that we were in, and he says to us, "You guys looking at wrestling figures?" And I'm like, "But like, yep." And I'm like, "We do it all the time. We go to Walmart. We do go to different stores and find them." He's like, "Oh yeah." He's like, "I like that too." Well, then this kid brings his father and I think it was I can't remember who else he was with, but the father said that they're going to WrestleMania.
Yeah, which is lucky.
I'm
I
like,
was trying to go to WrestleMania, but now we're going to be able to have WrestleMania come to us. But to be able to do that, especially for the first WrestleMania, it's just pretty awesome.
yeah, absolutely. And then the father was telling us about something called NCWA, North Carolina Wrestling Association or something like that. And he's like, it's out in Clayton, which is a few towns over from me. And he's like, "Have you ever looked into it? Have you ever been to it?" I'm like, "No," but I'm like, "We've been to, like, just in 2016 alone,
Yeah,
we've been to,
quite a few
quite
shows
a few
already.
shows, like three or four shows." And so he's like, "If you ever have the opportunity, check out NCWA. It's a bunch of old timers, the old school wrestlers,
Yes,
like."
so far what I looked it up, and the tickets aren't bad at all. You're looking for a VIP, $15. To get it for regular tickets, that's $10. So They'll be having Demolition there and a couple of other guys.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, Ivan Koloff, the Rock and Roll Express.
Yeah.
I think he said Sting was going to be there.
I'm sure he will.
But I know he's going to be at the big time wrestling event in February at the Dorton Arena. But some of the old school guys are in this NCWA, and he was talking about how some of the ROH stars of today actually got their start in the NCWA. And so I'm like, well, that's really cool. But yeah, VIP tickets, $15. And he's like, you know, it's for the most part, he's like, it's standing room only.
Mm-hmm.
And, but he's like, there's vendors that go there, mm-hmm. like people that sell their, like, their merchandise.
Yeah, so I'm sure they'll have figures like this, especially over there.
Yeah, hopefully. Mm-hmm. You know, I was telling, like, David on the way home, I'm like, if I find a booth that has an elite Sasha Banks
mm-hmm.
or any other really cool elites, I got to pick them up.
Yeah.
But, you know, that all depends on when, you know, the flow of income, if you will. So, you know, even for a $15 show, for VIP, got to buy some stuff, man.
Yeah.
So, so what do you... So overall, David, what'd you think about that kid and his family and the whole thing? Like, we tore up Walmart.
Yeah, pretty much everywhere we went, we kind of tore up the place.
I know, I literally felt like Grimm's Toy Show.
Yeah.
Ebenezer Middlesdorf.
You weren't even trying to do it on purpose either.
I wasn't.
Yeah.
But, man, shit was just falling left and right.
But, for stuff falling like that, I might as well take it home with me. But, it's fine, though. I mean, I had that experience, too, before when I went to my local Walmart. I saw some wrestling fans there. They were looking at the figures and stuff, and they actually look around, like, on eBay and stuff. So, it's pretty cool, like, when you go to the store and then you meet up with wrestling fans and just have a chat for a while.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
nice experience.
It is. It's always a nice experience to interact with other wrestling fans, you know.
Yeah, so don't be afraid to say hello if you find us out there.
Yeah, absolutely. So anything else you wanted to add, David, before we end this video that's already gone on for well over 22 minutes?
Well, even though besides all that, but basically, as a recap, got the Hulk Hogan Elite figure, the Paige figure, and going back to the big old FYE.
Yep, DDP.
Bag,
Renee
Seth
Young.
Rollins, and the chocolate bar, which will be had for the UK tournament. So I don't know, might see live reactions for that. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, I think I'd like to do like a live reaction or like a review of the show. We'll write down the matches and tell you guys what we thought about them. So
yeah, so tonight is only just for part one. Part two of the tournament continues on for tomorrow for the finals and who's going to win the UK championship, which I'm actually liking a lot more the more I see the UK championship tournament title.
Yeah, that belt is a piece of work. Yeah. I mean, it...
Great job.
It really is. I mean, it is a sick, sick belt.
Yeah.
You know, and I mean, yeah, they took the outline of the WWE titles that they have, but the inside of the graph or the border and the side plates, it's really, it's a very, very priceless, to say the least.
Yeah, definitely indeed. But yeah, we'll definitely be talking about that a little bit more. So stay tuned for that for both channels as well. And a couple other things throughout. Not only for tonight, but for tomorrow. But yeah, it's been a hell of an interesting day, especially for the action figure toy.
Yeah, I'm exhausted. I'm ready to just, like, turn in. But, you know, we'll be watching the tournament, and it'll be good. Yeah. It'll be worth it.
Hell yeah, it will.
You know, and it's not like we can't sleep in tomorrow.
That's true.
Got the bacon, the eggs, the sausage for breakfast, so that'll be good.
Indeed.
And so...
We got the snacks, so we'll also...
Yeah, we got snacks and everything, so...
Yeah.
All in all, we had a good day so far.
yeah.
And we hope that you guys are enjoying your weekend. Mm-hmm. And we will see you guys on the flip side. And until that time that we do the live reactions or do the review for the UK tournament, we'll see you guys real soon. Talk to you guys later. Good afternoon, good evening, and good night from Boston Fan himself and
David Rivera, Flip Mind Project.
Yep, see you guys later.
See ya.